I'm here in a hotel in Mexico City. It's about 6:10 in the morning. About to take a taxi over to a friend's place to take a bus down to Oaxaca to do this spiritual ceremony, which I'm kind of nervous about. But I'm okay. Because I'm recognizing that, honestly, what it is to really believe that we are safe and we are protected. That Joshua 1:9. Have I not told you, do not be discouraged, do not be afraid, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you will go. And it's not about some Christian God. The same thing is present in every religion. If you start to believe that and have faith, we're talking about something higher here. We're not talking about something used to subjugate humanity. We're talking about the truth. To get to the pinnacle of humanity, you know, that there is something, there's life force, there is something powerful flowing through every single one of us. There's life, there's magic, there is something beyond our understanding. And I think that's kind of what I'm afraid about the ceremony, is the little saints, as they call them, it's going to be stepping out of my mind, and I think it's a control thing. You know, so I truly want to give my will over to something. We'll see. All right, so we just arrived at the hotel in Huatla de Jimenez. I don't know if you can see. But it's quite large, actually. And, so, here we are. I have no idea what to expect. You know, it was about a 9-hour bus ride or so, something like that. A few stops here and there. I think it's gonna be a really amazing experience. I mean, who the fuck knows? I don't know, I've been reading A Course in Miracles the whole way up. And I'm day 20 on The Course in Miracles, which is all about some really intense shit. It's all the same shit, people. It is all the same shit. You know, whether you're listening to some Indian guru, one that is all about love, or one that's all about financial abundance and telling you that you're just sick and broke and you're not an actual seeker, or whether you go to some, you know, life coaching seminar or some shit, Tony Robbins or Landmark, it's all the same shit. Or whether you go into the mountains in some little cabin with a curandera, you drop some mushrooms, it's all the same shit. That we're all connected. Don't be a dick. So, I'm here in Huatla de Jimenez, in Oaxaca, and it's the day after the ceremony. It was pretty remarkable. There's so much. In the ceremony, I was like, oh, I didn't need to do this. But it's that whole paradox, it's all full of paradoxes. I think it's because you see from different places. You're starting to see from different places, so they go against each other. When you're still operating, starting to operate from two minds, your mind and the mind of God, your ego, you know, and the higher self, and I needed to come down here to find out that I didn't need to come down here, but I did need to come down here. Basically, what I did realize is that. It's all a big joke, right? I get the whole idea of this cosmic joke that none of it matters. None of it means a goddamn thing. None of it. And some of you might be like, what? No, but this bit, no, it means nothing. It means nothing except that what we make it mean, right? Which is a lot. It's huge. It's everything to us. But in the bigger scheme, atrás de las emociones, atrás de la verdad, atrás de los pensamientos, atrás de todo, is Dios. And, you know, and Dios and God only because I don't know what the better word is, but it's everything. It's again, it's behind the emotions. It's what's behind the thoughts. It's what's behind the truth. It's what's behind life. It's like if you are observing, trying to observe God, you can't. It's the observer. It's that which observes, you know, and this is not anything new. I'm not saying anything that nobody else is saying. It's just things that I've read but understood it then in a profound way where nothing else mattered. It didn't, you know, whether you're vegan or not, you know, whatever you do, none of it matters. Detrás de las emociones, detrás de los pensamientos, detrás de la verdad, es Dios. Gracias a Dios. So I'm here in DF, Ciudad de México, Mexico City. About to leave in a few hours. I'm at the cathedral here in Zócalo Centro. It's amazing. Like, I feel like the words are the same, but my understanding of them are entirely different. So I feel like I could say the same things that I've been saying, but now I understand them in a, you know, as, it's like to understand as God. That doesn't mean that it's that everything is okay. Everything is beautiful, actually. It's, behind everything, you know? It's, like I said, the cosmic joke. That I didn't have to come to Mexico to find that out, that I knew that. That I don't have my, that I know nothing. You know, when I can truly give over my ego to God, any negative, disempowering thought for myself or others is just that. It's not of God. It's ego. Guilt, shame, fear, doubt, all these things are just the ego trying to exert itself. It's when I feel separate from anybody, if I feel separate from any other human being, if I'm thinking anything other than love, and beauty and grace, and living in that. And even as you go, you do pass through these painful things, it's changing our relationship and understanding those is different. That underneath that, that the emotions, the feelings, the thoughts, all that passes, if you can really truly stay connected to something deeper, some immovable, immutable thing that is God, then anything is possible. Anything is possible. So one of the things I definitely learned, it was kind of funny during the ceremony, I realized I did not have to come all the way down here to do this. But I did have to come all the way down here to do this in order to learn that I didn't have to come all the way down here to do this. So it wasn't like a regret, it was a laughing at it, because everything was just a joke. Everything was fine. People were weeping and going through things, and I did as well. But I knew that behind all that, none of that is real. Anything that changes, anything that can die, anything that can break is not real. So the body is not real. Our mind, we can change our mind. Our minds are not real. Our thoughts are not real. You know? And it sounds like a bunch of pretentious bullshit, but it's from a different understanding entirely. That none of it exists. And it's not to be like, none of this exists, you can't touch anything. No, of course you can touch anything. But it is not eternal. It's not real. It changes, it fades. It's an illusion. It's Maya, as they call it, right? Not Maya like this Maya, Templo Mayor. Although this isn't Maya, but you know, it's Mexican. You don't know that. You don't know it's not Maya. I didn't know either, right? How would I know? How could you know? How the fuck would you know Mexican history? How would you know who the fuck Benito Juarez is? Yo sé ahora. I love you. Peace.
What? Too much?
Oh. Okay, esta canción.
¿Te gusta?
Sí, pero mi familia.